Welcome to the Office 365 update for June of 2018. In the next few minutes, I'll be giving you a quick rundown of the latest Office 365 updates with the goal of helping you get the most out of the service. Newsflash, new capabilities in any product or service do nobody any good unless people actually use them. For Office 365, one challenge to using new capabilities is knowing they exist and what value they provide. That's the focus of this video. Another hurdle, and one I frequently hear from listeners, is training users on how to use Office 365 capabilities, both new and existing, to get work done. While I've touched on some great training already available in past videos and provided links to training resources in the companion blog, there is also news on that front. On May 21st, Microsoft announced Microsoft Training Services, a digital, customized learning service for Office 365 and Windows 10. The training is designed to help customers leverage learning to transform their organizations without investing heavily in training and change management resources. To date, 25 organizations have participated in the pre-pilot phase, helping to develop and test the service, which includes customizable, always up-to-date content, experiences right-sized to an organization's needs, and metrics on training materials users consume and the types of custom playlists they create and share. Microsoft Training Services will be available as a pilot in late July 2018. To be added to the pilot waitlist or to learn more, register at https://aka.ms/mtspilot. New Outlook features across Windows, Mac, web, and mobile help you manage your time and keep what matters most front and center. Adding a new meeting or a location for an event just got easier and faster in Outlook for iOS. Even before you start typing, Outlook offers suggestions for your meeting location, including recently used conference rooms and other common locations, such as my office. Once you start to type in the location field, Outlook suggests options, powered by Bing, and then auto-completes your meeting location with the necessary information, including the full address for public locations. In iOS, Outlook will use your current location, your destination address, and traffic updates to send you a notification to let you know when it is time to leave for your next meeting. Note that this feature will be coming soon to Outlook for Windows. Let's face it, some meetings are more important than others. Don't tell my boss, but one criterion I sometimes use to determine if I'm going to attend a meeting is who else is going to be there. Up until recently, determining who would be attending a meeting could be challenging because meeting invitation responses were only visible to the meeting organizer. Now, Outlook allows you to see the tracked responses and RSVPs for the meetings you're invited to, even if you're not the organizer. This insight enables you to better manage your time and decide if you should attend based on the plans of others. For example, if I'm invited to two meetings that overlap, and I can see that one of my colleagues is attending one of the meetings, I could elect to attend the other meeting and then sync with my colleague afterwards. If you are planning a meeting that requires tight control of the attendee list, Outlook now gives you the option to allow or prevent the forwarding of your calendar invitation. Do you collaborate with people in different time zones? I do every day. That's why I was thrilled when the Outlook team added more time zone functionality to Outlook. This has become indispensable when I'm planning meetings and looking for time zone friendly meeting times. In Windows, you can now display up to 3 time zones in your calendar grid. Just click on File, then Options, then on the Calendar section. Under Time Zones, you can add whichever time zones you'd like to see. In Outlook for Mac, you can add 1 additional time zone under Outlook Preferences. Now at a glance, you can understand what's happening and when around the globe with Outlook. The April 30th Office blog post has additional details on all these features, as well as a preview of new features coming soon to Outlook on iOS and Android, including the ability to sync your drafts folder from your desktop to your mobile device, Office Lens functionality for adding captured whiteboards, documents, and photos directly to new Outlook messages, and the ability to tag your favorite people to keep your key contacts front and center in your mobile search experience, and more. I'll keep you posted on when these new features become available in future videos. At the May SharePoint conference in Las Vegas, several exciting features were announced for both SharePoint and OneDrive. Here are some of the highlights. First, improvements in the built-in scan feature in OneDrive mobile app for both iOS and Android. It's now accessed from the dedicated icon in the tab bar, making it easy to add images, multiple page files, and annotations right to your OneDrive. There's also improved upload support in OneDrive for Business with automatic uploads for photos and videos captured to your phone's camera roll. Another new feature is the ability to set and require a password when you share a file or folder with other people. This prevents others from accessing your files if your intended recipient accidentally forwards or shares the link. Note that this feature is independent from the secure external sharing controls managed by IT administrators. In addition, you now have the ability to prevent users from downloading files shared via view-only links. This enables you to share Office documents in the cloud while preventing people from downloading and keeping offline copies. There are several feature enhancements specific to Office 365 administrators, including the ability to automatically connect and synchronize SharePoint team sites as part of a OneDrive deployment or upgrade process. For all the details and additional news, read the OneDrive blog post I linked to in the transcript and resources document. One news item that generated a lot of buzz at the SharePoint conference was Microsoft's unveiling SharePoint Spaces. Leveraging Microsoft's investment in artificial intelligence and mixed reality, SharePoint Spaces are immersive, mixed reality experiences that enable users to view and interact with content from every angle. They can also visualize and manipulate data and product models in real time. With this innovation, SharePoint will become the first unified content collaboration and services solution to span files, websites, and soon, mixed reality spaces. Customers and partners can apply to be part of an early, limited preview of SharePoint Spaces by clicking on the link in the May 21st Microsoft blog post. The title bar has been a fixture in the Windows interface since the first version released to manufacturing 32 years ago. I'm happy to report title bar functionality in Office 365 has taken a huge leap forward in the name of productivity improvement. Click on the title bar and a new drop-down menu enables you to take several actions, including quickly renaming the current document, open the document's location, share the document via an invitation or link, and quickly access the document's version history. Truth be told, I sort of stumbled across this hidden gem in the Windows version of Office recently myself. But since doing so, I've particularly found the ability to open the document's location to be a big productivity booster. Give it a try, and I'm sure you'll find how much it can speed up your work. On May 25th of this year, enforcement began on a European privacy law, the General Data Protection Regulation, better known as GDPR. This law imposes new rules on companies, government agencies, nonprofits, and other organizations that offer goods and services to people in the European Union, or that collect and analyze data tied to EU residents, regardless of where the organization is physically located. GDPR is obviously a huge topic that we cannot adequately address in the time we have together, but we can at least get you started. One essential step to meeting GDPR obligations is discovering and controlling what personal data the organization holds and where it resides. Many Office 365 solutions can help you identify and manage access to personal data, including data loss prevention, advanced data governance, Office 365 e-discovery, and customer lockbox. A second core requirement of GDPR is protecting personal data against security threats. Current Office 365 features that safeguard data and identify when a data breach occurs include advanced threat protection, advanced security management, and Office 365 audit logs. I've provided links in the transcript and resources guide to pages in the Microsoft Trust Center that address GDPR and what Microsoft is doing to safeguard individual privacy with the Microsoft Cloud. That's all we have time for. Remember to send your feedback or success stories to Office 365 Update Series at Microsoft.com. I'm Jim Narosky. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.